good afternoon. It's a beautiful sunny afternoon in the moment. Temperatures in the 30s. And this is a response to Sepp of Waldhandwerk from my two favourite knives. Wouldn't be a surprise. First favourite knife. It's gotta be close to a barong machete. Try to sum it there if I can. Beautiful leaf shape, 1055. Very grippy, rubbery handle. And out of it at the end, I'd never let go of this thing. That's the first. Second favourite knife has nothing to do with favouritism, but it's the one I won from his Swedish stove competition, which is the Bushforce 2000. It's in stainless, not in carbon. Why do I like it? Big handle, big blade, really deep. And the Scandi grind is evil, but there's no point in me talking about it. Let's see what they do. You'll see this thing cuts like nothing I've ever experienced. Beautiful, beautiful bushcraft blade. So, let's just prove why I like them so much. See you in a bit. Okay, so, why do I like that barong so much? Quite simply, when I get to camp, it's there and it's able to do some phenomenal tasks, okay? That, you've seen me cut steak, you've seen me cut the string off the steak, okay? But it's also, it's the donkey work that it's good at. So I'm going to chop through this log now, see how long it takes. You know, I can really put some steam into this thing, okay? The barong machete against this log. If I was using an axe, I'm sure I'd be more out of breath. Yes, I'm swinging hard, because it's so light, the power goes in and it cuts so deep. Now, one swing is in. I mean, it's not the best log in the world, but it's just so much energy is deliberately and effectively gone into the cut, so you can really wedge bits out. But even then, as a chopper, it's brilliant. When it's coming out of the finer tasks, it's just as good. Look at this here. Don't leave any. Okay. That's the matter in hand. Okay. Delicate tasks with the barong machete. So I have a small baton, a piece of wood I need to split down. Let's say I need something out of here, like a hearth or make a fish slice or some utensil. Now, I'm putting the blade on top of there. I'm banging down right on the spine. Now I got a crazy little split. Now he isn't a wedge sort of blade, but it's got the span and the handle that allow me to split the wood. There. So that's that bit done. I'll choose a place maybe there. Right there. shop hands, can be left or right hand on this thing. Overton. Okay, so there's my piece come out the middle. And then literally it's just a case of, if I wanted a horror, you know, get rid of that bit like that and chop another, just be easy as anything. Okay, and you just draw your depression in there. Let's say I wanted, where's the flattest part? It's about there. So I want to get rid of that piece. So I only want that there because that's a bit twisted. So say to roll of this. And then, literally using the tip of the blade, picking this off, cutting with the grain. Get a good start for the spindle going. Okay, so let's say you want to do something even finer. Let's say the beginnings of a fish hook. Obviously, that's a bit thick, so there. I'm interested in that much there, so go. See how I want that there. Beginnings of a very large fish hook. Okay, so obviously you get a horn, stick it on there, something that big. Alright, and you can still shave the corners off. Looks like a little mini fish hook. And of course, the other little fine, delicate task is using pepper sticks. So, I don't know, find some. It'll do it. But it's far better doing it like this, using the weight. Quicker, so you go like that. There you go. Now you can really mess the wood up. Split it down loads. Great knife. Best thing is the price. Problem one thing, you can't get it anymore. Why it was discontinued, I've no idea. Of all of them that had the most mass, they had the Sayax, they had the Bowie, the Spear Point. This one, to me, had the most metal, because it's really fat in the middle. It actually rises above the handle. The handles now are harder plastic, this is more rubbery. I think it's the best one they ever made with their machete range, and discontinued it, but at least they've got one. Okay, so that's the first knife, the Barong machete. Oh, the bush horse 2000. when this thing arrived in the post, Yeah, nice more, it's clear, but when you actually take it out of the sheath and you offer it up to something else, it's so much deeper than the blade. And the thing off, I'm going to compare it stainless with carbon. Carbon bites, stainless seems to slide through the wood. So what I'm finding is it seems to take less energy to actually go through. It glides through. It's just effortless. It seems to be a shinier, more oily sort of steel. Still takes an edge. Just goes on and on and on and on. And we want to bite it, get the chest lever grip. Gone. Dang, it's gone every time. It's a wonderful knife. The handle's big. I can feel the steel somewhere around here. It is massive in the hand. And it just cuts. But it cuts deep. Look at that. I'm just going to go in and curl it out. I've got nothing to hang on to, alright? It's not pulling it out of my fingers. It's just slicing through. Amazing piece of kit. You know, feathering, ridiculous on this. Hardly any resistance at all in the wood. Beautiful. Great piece of kit. So the Mora Bush Horse 2000. Because I want it through set, it's a brilliant bit of kit. So hopefully that's good enough for you, my friend. Two great knives, undoubtedly. Cost the Barong machete. 12 inches of 10.55. Not because you give it to me. It's a beauty. Bush Horse 2000. All this, just got one more squeeze.